Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nikhil, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, teaching Christianity and Sikhism. This is the second part of the videos I'm making on the my late father's pamphlet. And what made people of the same country, India, and tribe, that is Jat, Aroda, Khatri, kill their own children, old people, and dishonor their own women folks, even are sometime of the same surname, you know, that blackened the face of, or led to disgrace our country, India, will be revealed in this pamphlet. Without any enmity, people killed children, disgraced their women for bloodshed, looting, etc. Therefore, if truth was propagated instead of the falsehoods, falsehoods are called kood in Punjabi and kufr in Urdu, then we would not have either suffered killing, bloodshed, etc. of our own country people, nor killed people like Lala Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. So now, who has hesitated or avoided to propagate the truth that led to the division of India would be known to you on understanding this subject. The truth is that Hindu is a samaj, which we call panth in Punjabi, or in English a religious community. That means a spiritual self and not a tribe, a physical self. Physical self is born, physical self die, not the spiritual. So in during this, Hindu is similar to a Jew. A Jew is a spiritual self, not the physical self. Not a single Jew is born, not a single Jew died during the Holocaust, but people of different tribes, Levi tribe, Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, they died. In Hinduism, you become a son of man by telling your hund. Hund is a Punjabi word which means your existence or the tribal identity and residence, called jati or basi. This is, you know, a common term we have. Jati means the tribe, jat means to know, jati means the thing or the name that make you be known to the others, or basi means where you are residence or where you are living, village, town, or so and so. So it is false to declare Hindu a spiritual community as tribe. So if you say Hindu is a spiritual community, you know, that means belong to all over the world wherever you go, but tribe, they are limited, you know, to country where they come from. A division of mankind on blood basis, that means they said, you know, the Hindu is a division of man being a tribe, then it become the partner in the political affairs. The same falsehood applies when you become a Jew of physical self and not spiritual, not of the heart. Further, Aryan is a race on blood basis, like you have a Semitic race in the Middle East. Abraham belonged to Semitic race and he was not a Jew. And it was declared as Arya Samaj. Samaj means a community, a spiritual community to which anyone could join. So even a Negro can join a spiritual community, but he cannot become of the race of Arya. Arya race, you know, these Iranian, German, and all these are belong to Aryan race. Tribes are sons of race, and by declaring it a samaj, samaj means community, you are declaring it open to all races. That is how could a person of Negro race become an Aryan or become a member of the Arya Samaj? If it is of spiritual nature, Sikh, Muslim, etc. are the second spiritual communities, or we call it Punjabi Panths, or in Hindi Samaj. In Urdu we call them Millat. And they were declared as tribes, making them the secular selves, the same way as Jews are declared. The Jews have declared the physical selves are outwardly instead of inwardly. You know, these Jews, they have got the, they say their country belong to the Jew. That means they have made the spiritual self a tribal self or outwardly. Tribes participate in the secular world, and by declaring the spiritual selves, Hindu, Sikh, Muslims, etc., as the tribes or the secular selves or partners, they were allowed to usurp the political rights of the true tribal selves. That means you let the, when you change the tribal identity and let the other name, you know, to occupy that identity, then you make the other name to usurp the rights of the, what is, of the truthful rights of the original one. So the secular world belongs to tribes. And if you make the partners of the secular world Hindu, Sikh, Jew, Muslim, then you are making the Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, etc. to usurp the political rights of the tribes. Tribes are in India, we have a Jat. I belong to Jat tribe. Aroda, Khatri, Tarkhan, Lohar, there are so many tribes in India, countless, you know. They also declared Hindustani. These three leaders, you know, of political leaders they at that time were Lala Gandhi and his partners. They also declared Hindustani. Hindustani means nationality, you know, or Indian nationality, as tribe or qaum. Qaum is the Urdu word which stands for tribe. By doing so, you say bye-bye to your tribal fathers, or father or seed, and become an orphan without the tribal protection. So when you adopt a new tribal names, then to the tribe, to your tribal father, which are secular, which physical way of which you are born, you say to him, bye-bye, I don't want you. I got a new father. And then, you know, the protection is then taken away from you. I become an orphan. Hindustani or Indian nationality is your political mother, and it cannot be become the political father, the tribes. You only become the sons of your tribal father when you declare Pathan, Baloch, Gurkha, Marhatta, Khatri, Gaur, Moghal, Jat, Trahan, etc. as your tribes or qaums. Qaum is Urdu word. Without political father, tribe, you are a political orphan. We call it yatim. Such political orphans, having no backing or protection of the political fathers, the tribes, they are extremely weak to defend any invader. So anybody who come, he can just invade you, you know, because there is no protection. one who conceals one political father, tribe and residence, jati or vasi. Knowingly, such a person cannot be a Hindu, but a son of Satan, a political bastard that create mischiefs and bloodshed. So the antonym of a Hindu is a bastard, a son of Satan. In the Bible, they are called tares. The sons of man are called wheat plants. Matthew 13:24-30, you know. So these tares are bundled up in Israel now for final burning. Take, for example, the people of South India. One India, you know, we have a, you will be surprised how the people have different character or conscience. Take, for example, these people of South India have the names of their father and village incorporated in their names. Such people are Hindus, and they, being not the sons of Satan, live in peace. So in South India, you know, we have a each person has four names. First is the Christian name or forename, as mine is Rajinder. Then they will have the name of his father. My father's name was Udham. So in that one, you know, they will have incorporated. But in my name, it is not incorporated. I have just Rajinder, and my surname is Nijjar. But in the South, they will be incorporating the name of the father. In my case, it will be Rajinder Udham. And then the name of the village is Pandori. The village, I belong to Pandori Nijra. So Pandori we will put, that the, at the end will be my surname Nijjar. So it will constitute four elements. By my name, people will know who is my father and which village I come from. That is why, so people in that South India, you know, that's why they lived in peace, because each person had a sharm or conscience, or tribal conscience. He was the salt of the earth. I will come to that one later on. That is, no sectarian riots in the South, as in the Punjab, the hot spot of the sons of Satan. That is why Harmandir Sahib, the holiest of holy that used to be in Jerusalem, its replacement is called Harmandir Sahib. Hospital for the spiritually sick were established in the Punjab and not in the South, where Christ Thomas was enough light for this dark age. Remember, Christ Thomas, he was not saint, because at Pentecost, all those laborers, they were awarded their wage, which was Holy Spirit with capital S. So at Pentecost, they all became Christ, but not the anointed one. Jesus was the anointed one. So all the they were virgins that married the Son, Christ Jesus. So they became the twin brother of Christ Jesus. Those who become Satan knowingly by concealing their tribal identity, no Brahmin or Rabbi, as they call it in Middle East, will take them as their disciples for moral education, or they will become a true Sikh or Muslims. So they cannot make a spiritual progress, you know, if you conceal your tribal identity knowingly, that you become a thoughtless person knowingly. So think of the political leaders who proclaim to be Sikhs. I think I will do this one in the next videos, and hope it will make clear. Our Father, God, bless you.